Conjuring.
Hello everyone and welcome to another Division 2 video. Today we're going to explore a build that can easily break through Summit Legendary without much problem thanks to its extremely high survivability, and honestly once you master how you can move with this build, it will be next to impossible for you to be killed even in Legendary Summit. The only downside is it doesn't excel so much in high damage compared to other builds you may have seen here on the internet or you may have created yourselves, but sacrifices that damage to have extremely high survivability. And honestly, the hardest part I found to creating this build was a proper sidearm, because as a new player I've never focused to finding an optimized sidearm as I was rarely using it. And that's why I had a little hard time on farming it. Let's have a closer look at the gear pieces we're using, and we need 4 out of 6 Foundry Bulwark in order to achieve that high survivability with our shield. And please note that the chest and the backpack are raid exclusive, so unless you will be able to join a raid or have friends that can help you with a raid, you won't be able to take those, but fortunately we don't need those to have a proper build and go through Legendary Summit, because the 4 pieces give us a 10% total armor, the 3 piece bonus gives us a 1% armor regen and a 50% shield health, and the 4 piece bonus makes the high survivability of our build with the makeshift repairs. Whenever you or your shield take damage, 20% of that amount is repaired to you, to both of you, over 15 seconds. All gear set pieces for the Foundry Bulwark have armor as core attribute, which further increase your survivability plus your shield health, which helps a lot. So we need to focus a little bit of damage, and for that I recommend to use a Douglas and Harding set, one piece, either for the chest and backpack. I use it for the chest piece, and I also have the Intimidate talent, which gives you, while you have bonus armor, amplifies weapon damage by 35% to enemies within 10 meters, and the Douglas and Harding gives you 20% pistol damage, which increases the damage quite a bit. For the backpack, I do go for the memento as always. If you have it, it's quite great. It will give you the core attribute of armor plus 1 skilled hair, making our shield a maximum skilled hair 6 and giving it quite enough health. And not only that, you will get the bonus armor from the trophies and to combine it with Intimidate. In case you do not have access to the memento, I do recommend to use a backpack that has the Adrenaline Rush talent, which will give you bonus armor while you go near an enemy, which has only 5 second cooldown, and that way you will constantly have the bonus armor to combine it with Intimidate and always have the survivability plus the DPS increase that you will need. For the skills, I do use the Striker Drone to further increase a little bit my damage. And of course you have to use the Bulwark Ballistic Shield, which for me at tier 6 with a Bulwark 4 pieces Bulwark defense has a 14,800,000 and almost 50,000 hit points, and that's without the long term buff from the memento. For the sidearm, I do use a T50, although it's not the most accurate, it hits the hardest, and honestly after testing a couple of sidearms, I found this to be the best. It deals quite high damage, almost 1,000,000 after all the buffs, and it helps me a lot with the damage. For the specialization, I use the Firewall, but honestly you are free to use the Gunner or something else, or if you don't have a tier 6 shield, the Technician, but I like the Firewall because for the talent, when the armor breaks, it applies burn to the targets in case our armor breaks, which is a little rare. But most of the things, I like the health on kill, because most of the times the armor regenerates fast enough, but our health may not regenerate from some hazardous damage. For the weapons of choice, for the primary weapons, honestly it's up to you. I do have the mob for in case I need to do close and personal fast damage, but I rarely use it, and I need to have an assault rifle, and I prefer the FAMAS in case I need to destroy the EMP, because our biggest enemy are the EMPs, especially in the summit, and we need to destroy them as soon as possible from afar, because without our shield it's quite harder to survive and we cannot go close and personal to the enemies. For our stats, the starting gear that I'm using as well won't be so impressive. I did try and focus a little bit on headshot damage with the current weapon, but after I found something else, I did try to focus a little bit on critical hit chance and critical hit damage, and we will explore that in a little bit. But the stats we need to focus more are the defense stats, which are 1.7 million armor, 17,000 armor regen, and that's without any buffs from the memento, and we also have the health on kill. I don't have the maximum yet. I have, I think, 10%, which is 27,000, but I do intend to level it up to 30%, which will be further increased from the firewall specialization. Let's see how much the full stacks from the memento improves our skill. Our shield health now is 20 million, which it's quite great. And of course our damage will be increased by 30%. And the most important as well thing will be our armor regen will now be 68,000 armor generation per second, which will be combined as well with makeshift repairs from the Foundry Bulwark. And this helps a lot with your survival. Using all the stats and gear you saw in this video made me through many levels from the Legendary Summit, and I'm still trying to improve the build, of course, to find better pieces, to optimize the rolls. And as I told you, I found something accidentally, a secondary weapon that improves the build for its survival and its damage a lot, and that of course is the Liberty Sidearm. I saw that this exotic is a perfect fit for such build using a Bulwark shield. I knew I had to farm it, but I saw that probably because I was doing a lot of missions, I already had all the pieces needed plus a D50, and so I managed to craft it. And what makes it great, it has a lot more damage compared to the D50, and its specific talent makes it great, it's Liberty or Death. Its hit grants a 2% weapon damage, which stacks up to 30 times. A headshot consumes all stacks, repairing your shield for 3% per stack. That's both great because it gives you basically a 60% damage increase, and a headshot damage will probably repair your whole shield because it's 90% repair for the shield, and for the Bulwark shield that's quite a lot. After trying it myself in the Summit Legendary, I did see a difference. The damage increase is quite great, and once you need to heal the shield, if that it happens, usually if you have a heavy or many enemies ahead of you, you just go for one headshot and your shield is fully repaired. And that's why I needed to avoid focusing on headshot damage, because I need to focus on body shots to keep the stacks up, to further increase the damage. And honestly, with the damage increase, you will hit, as you see, 1.3, 1.5 million sometimes with all the buffs up, and keep that headshot when needed to heal the shield. Before proceeding to showing you only gameplay without any further commentary, just a few tips for those that are starting Legendary Summit. You need to keep in mind that enemies are quite smarter and do a lot of damage, meaning that they will try and flank you, and once they do that, you're not invincible. If someone is behind you and in front of you, you will take a lot of damage and they will be able to take you down. With that in mind, you need to try and have the enemy constantly in front of you. That's why I don't recommend on when you use any of the directives to have the fog of war off, because you need to make sure that no one is behind you. You need to focus on the healers first, on the medic, because they will raise the dead and that can complicate things. The more the enemy, the easier they will be able to flank you. And just be aware of the hardest floors in the summit are those with the EMP jammer, and especially with the indestructible EMP jammer, because sometimes you will need to go near the EMP jammer, take control over it before you will be able to destroy it. And for that I do recommend to do a tactic I was trying. I usually leave one enemy alive before doing that, usually a sniper, because he will go further away and hide, and then I go to disable the EMP jammer, kill the sniper, that will spawn more enemies usually, and then if you still have your shield you will be able to kill all of them. If you keep your distance of the EMP, of course, that's where you will be able to have your shield up. If the EMP is just further away, just try to hide, take your AK or other weapon you have and destroy those EMP jammers as far as you can, and be aware of the NPCs that throw the EMP jammers, that have some portable EMP jammers, because this can cause you a bit of problem. Of course, since you're using a build with only a pistol, you can take advantage of the directives such as Pistolero and Ammo Hoarders, which gives you zero disadvantage while using only a pistol, and also combine them with no regen and fragile armor. Although fragile armor, keep in mind, it's buggy sometimes, meaning you will not be able to remove the reduction of the armor even when using an armor kit, and you will have to log out or fast travel in order for the problem to be fixed. But the armor very rarely breaks for me, so I take advantage of that. Overall, the build is quite great for its survivability. Even for new players, you will be able to do Legendary Summit and with some directives without any problem, although be prepared to adjust your gameplay and for the extra time you will need to complete each floor compared to other higher damage builds. This is the build I will try to keep improving a little bit, because I do believe I will be able to probably try some legendary missions and not legendary summit, because the legendary missions are a little harder. It will take a little more of time, of course, to prepare, to do some tries, and if I'm successful I will prepare a separate video with all the details and probably more gameplay rather than explaining the build, because you will find all the necessary information you need here. As always, stay tuned for more upcoming videos for The Division and other games. Thank you very much for watching, and I wish you all a great day.
Dangerous target approaching.
Son of a bitch.
These blades!
contact.
Target is
I could do this all day.